Ito ha, I just want to warn you, because we will produce the two lawyers. If you cannot name it in today's hearing, I will cite you in contempt for lying. Just want to warn you. Huwag mo kaming burahin dito, Kevin Marcos. Are you still with the CIDG?
Yes po, sir.
Oh, General Toro, yung tao mo is telling a lie. He is lying in front of this committee.
With regards to the 5.1 billion freeze order by AMLAC being mentioned by Colonel Marcos, is it correct?
Your Honor, at present, there is a civil forfeiture case which is ongoing against Mr. Kerwin Espinosa. And the properties which are frozen at present, for the peso account, it's amounting to 1,235,439.90. And there is also a US dollar account in the amount of 502 dollars and 33 cents. Also, there are 11 real properties. This include a one residential lot worth 336,000 pesos. Another is one fishing ship, 17 motor vehicles, 4 motorcycles, 4 firearms, and 2 watercrafts. The asset preservation order on these properties were issued on the 31st of July 2017. So there is no 5 billion, Your Honor, that was frozen by the AMLAC. That might have been sourced from news articles.
General Marcos, can you comment on that?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Actually, kanina lumapit po ako kay sa taga-AMLA, sir. Prinobide ko sa kanya yung documents na prinobide din sa akin nung dalawang attorney ng taga-AMLA. Yung scheme...
Yes, sandali po. Yung documents coming from the AMLA, yes, dalawang attorney. Is it official and authenticated?
Hindi naman po, sir.
Oh, hindi dapat. So you should not mention in this committee those documents. It's not official.
Pati po yung...
Sige na, sadali. Yes, sama na. You should not use it in your statement, those documents that is not official. Oh, yes. And who is that two attorneys from AMLAC?
Pilit ko pong i-recall.
Now you don't recall. Now you can't recall. Can you recall it or not?
Nandun po sa isang cellphone ko, sir.
Sa
isang cellphone ko na hindi ko na ginamit. At saka nag-provide po ako ng cheque na nandun po yung corporation.
Blue. Sadali.
Opo.
Sadali. Dandahan mo na. I'm just asking you about that 5.1 billion. And you tell this committee that your source is the two attorney or lawyer from the AMLAC. Now, I told you that is not an official document. Correct?
It could be, hindi ba siya authenticated, sir?
Oh, that's why you cannot use it. Dandahan ka po dito sa committee nito. Second, you cannot anymore remember the two lawyers from AMLAC?
Pardon, sir?
Hindi mo na matandaan yung dalawang abogado?
Pili ko nire-recall, pero sigurado ako, sir, nandun sa isang cellphone ko po yung...
How did you get that information? You talk to them? Personally?
We were ongoing, sir, with the financial...
Sadali, you talk to them, yes or no? Personally?
Personally, sir.
Also, you cannot remember the names? You talk to them personally, but you cannot remember the names? Even surname or family name? So you can name the two lawyers? As you have mentioned, you talk to them personally. But now you cannot mention the name.
It was 7 years ago.
Sorry?
Yung pangalan nila, sir, at saka yung cellphone number, nandun po sa isang cellphone ko, sir.
No, I'm not asking about the cellphone number. I'm asking about the names because if you have... Is the two lawyers assigned in the central office?
Sir?
Naka-assign ba po
yung dalawang lawyer sa central office ng AMLA?
Possible, sir.
But possible? You're a CIDG intelligence officer and you never checked the background of the two lawyers you mentioned?
Actually,
and that is the source of your 5.1 billion telling in this committee?
Actually, sir, these two lawyers conducted seminar on all CIDG personnel and regional
officers. When was that? Ito, lumalamlin tayo.
2016.
Saan sir, yung seminar na yan?
It was 2016, sir. Training kami pertaining to money laundering.
Saan yan?
Dito, sir, sa Manila, lahat ng RC.
Saan sa Manila?
Isang hotel, sir.
Saan hotel? Hindi mo na naman matandaan yung hotel.
Actually, the training, sir, is mandatory for regional.
Hindi nga, I'm asking about the hotel. You cannot mention the name. Now you're telling us that there is a seminar in that hotel. And what is that hotel? Because we have to check that hotel. If indeed there's a seminar on that day.
I'll try to recall, sir. Doon ko po nakilala yung dalawang lawyer.
Eto, Colonel Marcos, ha? Eto, I just want to warn you.
Mr. Chair.
Eto, this is your first offense of lying.
Mr. Chair.
Yes.
With the indulgence of the Honorable Paduano.
With the indulgence of Congressman Paduano.
One question.
Yes, Congressman Naakop, you're recognized.
Colonel Marcos, yung information regarding yung 5 billion ba, was it voluntarily given you or did you ask for it?
It was voluntarily given to me, sir.
Because then it is mandatory that you recall the names of the two AMLAC. Because that is not appropriate.
Yes, sir. I will give, sir, the two names, sir.
Kami nga, hindi nga namin basta-basta makuha yung kwan kung walang predicate crime, eh.
I will provide the two names, sir.
Because yes, provide it. Otherwise, I will agree with the Honorable Paduano that you should be cited in contempt. Kasi sinagot mo yung katanungan sa katanungan ni Honorable Rodriguez Gutierrez kanina. Yes.
Sir,
ikaw ang nag-volunteer noon na yung kwan ni Mr. Espinosa, ang transaction is worth 5 billion.
Can I explain a little, sir? Nung binigay po sa akin yung information...
Hindi kita tinatanong. Ang tinanong ko lang sa iyo is, did you ask for the details or binolunteer ng AMLAC?
It was voluntary given to me because mayroon po silang binigay na documents on the scheme of the money laundering. Nandito po sa cellphone. Yun po ang binigay.
Thank you, Honorable Paduano.
Chairman, please proceed. AMLAC, is it normal? Kasi kami dito, pag nag-request kami, doon sa asset freezing of assets, ang daming requirements. But Colonel Marcos is telling this committee na binigay sa kanya voluntarily that allegedly that 5.1 billion asset. And looking at your records, nandito ngayon hawak ko, and you mentioned it, wala. Di ba? Kaya is it normal, AMLAC?
Your Honor, for the meeting that Colonel Marcos mentioned, well, it's a usual occurrence for us to have coordination meetings with our counterparts, Your Honor. But as to the disclosure of transactions, I'm not really sure if... me as an investigator, when we conduct these meetings, we don't readily disclose information. Because of the bank secrecy law and...
Sir, naalala ko na. Si General Lubusan, sir, yung dalawang lawyer na taga-AMLA, inutusan niya, sir, na pumunta ng Tacloban para harapin ako, sir, because I was ongoing investigation on a Metro Bank account also pertaining to drug money. Ngayon, sir, kaya ako na-meet, sir, yung dalawang lawyer. Hindi ko naman sila personal na kilala, pero... Sinabi ni General Lubusan doon sa AMLA dalawang lawyer, pumunta kayo kay Colonel Marcos sa Region 8. You coordinate with him. He will give you all the information.
Oh, Colonel Marcos, you're now changing your story. Tama?
It is how I meet Sir Da two lawyers.
Sandali.
Opo, sir.
So you're now changing your story? Yes or no?
Hindi naman po, sir. Doon ko sila.
Anong hindi? You tell this committee a while ago that during your seminar, then all of a sudden, inutusan na certain General Busa Ito, problema pa, papatawag namin si General Busa. And if he deny it, lagot ka.
Both occasions, sir, are true. Yung una, sir, na-meet ko sila dahil pinapunta sila ni General Ubusan sa Region 8. Mag-coordinate sa akin.
Dali.
After that, sir, dahil hindi si kumbinsido yung taga-AMLA sa knowledge namin pertaining to financial investigation on money laundering, nagpakandak po si General Ubusan ng seminar. Yun po. Doon ko na naman sila po na-meet uli.
So, nauna yung pagpunta nila sa Leyte?
It was the first time that I met them kasi inutusan silang pumunta ng OTSO para mag-coordinate sa akin, may bigay ko yung mga impormasyon na kailangan nila. At the same time, sir, nakonvince sila na yung mga chief ng CIDG hindi equipped pertaining to financial investigation.
Mr. Chair.
So, nagpakandak ko, sir, ng seminar.
Mr. So, your indulgence of General Akop, Chairman Akop, after me. Ito na lang po, so you're telling that the two lawyers you cannot mention is lying?
Lying po.
Lying. Because on record, there is a such thing as 5.1 billion. So they're lying, but still you cannot mention their name?
It is the, ano sir, a Blue Oceanic Corporation textile.
No! What? Answer directly my question. Diba? Sinabi mo 5 billion, 5.1 billion. Now we check with AMLA, wala. Now you're telling this committee that the two lawyers in which until now we cannot mention is lying?
Wala naman sila dito, sir, para i-deny yung sinasabi ko.
Ah, hindi! This is record! Nako, Colonel Marcos, are you a lawyer?
Hindi naman po.
Okay, wag kang mag-lawyering dito.
Hindi po ako nag-lawyering.
Papalusot ka, I am not a lawyer, pero hindi ka pwedeng lumusot dito.
Sir, it's an honest to goodness information, sir. Wala akong motibo, sir, na...
Hindi, kaya nga yung tinatanong ko, kasi kanina hindi naman tinanong sa'yo. Ikaw mismo voluntarily, when you are being asked by Kong Rhodes. Now, hindi mo ma-mention yung pangalan. Now, nandito na yung dokumento, official document. Oh, still, are you insisting?
Yung po kasi ang binigay na info sa akin, sir.
You cannot produce the name? Then you will tell this committee that you're telling the truth?
Nandun kasi, sir, sa isang cellphone ko yung pangalan. Pinipilit ko pong i-recall, sir. Pasensya na po.
Bakit nandun? Bakit anong nandun sa binigay ka ba ng cellphone number?
Nirecord ko po yung mga pangalan niya, sir.
Oh, do you have the document? Official document that you were ordered by a certain General Bosa to meet that to AMLAC personnel or lawyers?
Tinawagan lang po ako, sir, ni Director.
Oh, yun ang problema. Because that instruction is verbal.
Oh, verbal, sir.
Oh. So, verbal, okay ka?
Sir?
Okay sa'yo na verbal. Verbal instruction.
Bali, tinawagan ako ni General Lubusan na may pupunta sa
akin. Okay, kaya nga eh. Okay sa verbal instruction na napaka-sensitive. It's all about acid nung Espinosa.
Oh, there were ongoing investigation noon, sir.
Oh, yun yung problema mo, Tony.
Ongoing po.
Colonel Marcos, yun ang problema mo. Ito ah, i-hold ko muna. Yes, Chairman Akop.
Mr. Chair, ang tanong ko lang, sabi mo na naman ngayon, nautusan ka ni General Ubusan, who I presume was the chief of the CIDG then.
Yes, sir.
Siya ang boss mo. Inutusan ka, sinabihan ni General Ubusan yung dalawang AMLAC na pumunta sa iyo kasi ikaw ang nakakalam. Tama ba yung pagkarinig ko sa sagot mo?
Opo, sir. Tama po, sir.
Ano yung bagay na iniimbestiga ng AMLAC? At bakit lumabas doon yung 5.1 billion na sinasabi na financial transaction ni Mr. Kerwin Espinosa?
Kasi during that time, sir, I was, dahil ako ang regional chief ng CIDG 8.
Sinabi ba nila? Sinabi ba nila na ang iimbestigahan nila yung financial transaction ni Mr. Kerwin Espinosa?
Yes po, sir. Yun ang specific na pakay nila, sir.
Ay, mandatory na sabihin mo yung pangalan ng dalawang AMLAC.
Opo, sir.
Chairman, can I proceed?